Hello children, in this video we are going to do session 11 of unit 4 web applications and security. Protect health and safety at work. Hazards and sources of hazards. So what are the different dangers and the sources of dangers that can happen to an individual? An organization can face some health hazards that could put the lives of the employees in danger. A hazard is anything that is the source of any potential harm, damage, or any kind of potential loss of health or life. Okay, so hazard is what? It is something which can harm any person. Okay, it can harm the health of the person and it can also harm to the life. It can lead to the danger of life of person. Hazards can be of different types depending on the industry and the environment in which the employees are working. Okay, so they can be of different types. The harms can be of different types. The different type of hazards include physical, chemical, biological, and mechanical, right? So here we have the sources of hazards. The workstation should provide sufficient space for the user to alter position comfortably. So there should be sufficient space in the workspace so that the users or the employees can do their work in a good position, right? They can properly sit there, they can properly stand there. Okay, there should be proper space. Provide adequate lighting. There should be adequate lighting, proper lighting in the work environment so that they can see properly. Have windows fitted with adjustable coverings to alter the sunlight levels. So the work environment should have the windows with the coverings so that they can adjust the covering according to the sunlight. Be spacious enough when a workstation is shared by more than one person. Okay, when a workstation is shared by more than one person, it should be spacious so that both the employees can get the inner space. The display screen should display well-defined characters of adequate size and spacing. Okay, if you are working on the screen, then the characters on the screen should be of adequate size so that you can see them easily, have a stable image. Right, the images should not be blurred, or they should not be tilting image, right? They should be stable, have easily adjustable brightness and contrast. You can easily adjust the brightness and contrast of your screen. Tilt and swivel is easily to shoot the user. Be free from glare and reflections. It should not be, your screen should be free from glares and reflections. Use a separate base for the screen or an adjustable table, right? So these are the different alternatives or different measures that you should have for the proper workplace. Then you, in the keyboard should be able to tilt easily and should be able to separate from the screen to allow the user to adopt a comfortable working position. And if you are using the keyboard, you should be able to keep the keyboard according to your comfortable position. Have space in front to provide support for the hands or arms for the user. So it should be that much spacious that so that you can provide the support to the arms and the hands. Have a matte surface. Okay, have clearly legible symbols on the keys. Okay, the keys should have the clear symbols on them. The work surface should provide adequate space for the user. Have a low reflective surface. Be of an adequate size to allow the screen, keyboard, and other peripherals to be flexibly arranged. So it should be having the adequate space so that the user or the worker can easily arrange them according to his comfort, right? Have a stable and adjustable document holder which should be at the same level as the screen and at the same wing distance. Okay, so there should be the adjustable document holder, okay, which should be at the same level as the screen and at the same wing distance. So these are the different alternatives. These are the different measures that we should have for the proper work environment. Now we have the workplace evacuation. The key, in case of emergency, there should be provision for evacuation. Evacuation is the process of emptying a place in case of emergency disaster. Agar koi emergency hoti hai, koi disaster hoti hai, that you should leave that place immediately. आपको वो प्लेस इमिडिएटली खाली कर देना है, उसको बोलते हैं इवैक्यूएशन, राइट? एवरी कंपनी मस्ट एंश्योर फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स फॉर इवैक्यूएशन इन केस ऑफ एनी इमरजेंसी. अगर कोई इमरजेंसी होती है तो आपको कौन से मेजर्स लेने हैं. एंड इवैक्यूएशन पॉलिसी, एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड हैव द इवैक्यूएशन पॉलिसी. एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मस्ट हैव एन इवैक्यूएशन पॉलिसी. ऑल द टीम लीडर्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इन्फॉर्मिंग अबाउट द पॉलिसी टू देयर एम्प्लॉइज अबाउट इट. प्रॉपर अटेंशन मस्ट बी पेड व्हेन द टीम लीडर इज इन्फॉर्मिंग यू अबाउट दीज डिटेल्स. नेग्लिजेंस एट दिस टाइम मे कॉस्ट लाइव्स. सो एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड हैव अ प्रॉपर पॉलिसी ऑफ इवैक्यूएशन इफ एनी डेंजर कम्स, राइट? Organization must have a designated assembly point for emergencies. Ensure that every employee worker must know where it is. हर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में कोई ऐसा प्लेस होना चाहिए जहाँ पे इमरजेंसी के टाइम पर असेंबल होने का क्राइटेरिया हो, और जितने भी एम्प्लॉयज वहाँ वर्क करते हैं उनको वो इमरजेंसी प्लेस पता होना चाहिए जहाँ पे वो जाएं जब कोई इमरजेंसी होती है. A buddy system for individuals with special needs or disabilities must be designated. This system ensures that differently abled are assisted and guided out of the premises or the impacted area properly. If you are a buddy to someone, ensure that your buddy is safe at the assembly point with you. Every organization should have a buddy system. Har organization mein buddy system hona chahiye. In that system, you becomes buddy to a particular person which is having some physical disability. So that if any emergency comes, what happens? You along. Not only you always try to take your buddy to the safe place, to the assembly place, right? In case of buddy system, it is your responsibility to take your buddy to the safe place, the person who is not physically able to go to that place, right? Then we have the floor plans with evacuation routes in work area. Ensure that you understand these so you can use it in time of need. Okay, so if any emergency situation comes, there should be floor plans. Floor plans means everybody should know that in by which floor that particular individual will go to the secure place, right? Stair plans, there should be the stair plans ki aapko is stair se jana hai, aapko is floor se jana hai. Aisa na ho ki sare log ek hi jagah se agar jayenge to kya hoga, to wahan pe wo itna jyada rush ho jayega, they will move over to each other, right? Assembly area where you are required to assemble after evacuation must be properly taken care of. और वो assembly area जहाँ पे आपको assemble होना है उसको हमेशा तैयार रहना चाहिए, right? उसको हमेशा उसकी proper maintenance होनी चाहिए. Periodic evacuation drills should be conducted. Ensure that you pay attention during these drills. और इवैक्यूएशन ड्रिल्स होनी चाहिए जिससे पता चले, एम्प्लॉयज को पता चले कि अगर ऐसी कोई सिचुएशन आती है देन हाउ दे विल बिहेव एंड हाउ व्हाट दे विल डू. ओके, व्हाट इज द वे टू गो टू द सिक्योर प्लेस. हेल्दी लिविंग, अ हेल्दी बॉडी हैज अ हेल्दी माइंड. A very popular saying is true. Okay, we know that if our body is healthy, our mind is healthy. Healthy lifestyle leads to a healthy being. A healthy living has a lasting impact on an individual, which ultimately yields a healthy environment at home as well as at workplace. A happy and healthy worker will always perform best to his ability. We know that if we are healthy, we have the healthy mind and our work ability gets increased, right? Okay, so it is the responsibility of an organization to keep their employees healthy. A healthy lifestyle helps to keep and improve people's health and well-being. A healthy lifestyle includes healthy eating habits. We should have the healthy eating habits, physical activities, stress management, healthy mind, sound sleep and goal setting. A healthy lifestyle technique, practice commitment and sincere effort. Stay healthy, stay happy.